travelled outside the Limerick boundary, but of course Cavanagh's having such a strong association and link with County Limerick, particularly West Limerick, is the reason we're here to pay tribute to them this morning on the Artane Boys Band Whistle Stop Tour of Limerick County in this All-Ireland Hurling Final Week in the run-up to the All-Ireland Senior Hurling Championship Finals at Croke Park, which we're all anxiously awaiting for on Sunday next. And everybody here, of course, will be cheering for Limerick. Well done.
It's a great day for Cavanaghs.
It is a great day. The crack here all the week was brilliant. But I'm looking for a ticket actually for Sunday, but Trixie said he'd fix me up before the weekend.
What's it like to be a Corkman and not involved in an All-Ireland?
Well, kind of last time Cork won an All-Ireland, I was too young to kind of get the crack, like, you know, but now I know what I'm missing and next year we'll make up for it. We'll be there next year.
Tom Nelligan, looking forward to the game?
Very much so, Mel. I think it'll be a great game and a great. I think this year now has been a great advertisement for the game of hurling in Ireland, and hopefully things will go right and we'll have the right result at the end of the day.
Limerick need to make up for the disappointment of 2 years ago.
They do, yeah. It was a big disappointment 2 years ago, but I don't think that'll be in the back of their minds. I think they'll have to concentrate on their game against Wexford, but I think they'll have the right mental frame of mind, and I think they will win it.
Martin Condon, Managing Director. Nice to have the Artane Boys Band here in County Cork for a Limerick special occasion.
Oh, brilliant, absolutely brilliant. Yeah, when Seamus came along on Thursday and told us that was happening, we didn't believe it. Actually, most of the lads didn't believe it at all. And I got a few phone calls from town saying, are you having us on? And, you know, I wasn't really sure, but it was brilliant. Absolutely, we were thrilled.
I'm sure you'll be there at Croke Park to see them on Sunday as well.
Oh, certainly, we'll be there, yeah.
Looking forward to the match. It was a Mona Gay man once upon a time, captain of the Limerick team.
That's right, Mal. Bill Hawk, and hopefully we can have another Mona Gay man next Sunday, bring home an All-Ireland medal.
How confident are you this year compared to 2 years ago?
I think our team is more seasoned, more mature. Obviously, 94... was very disappointing for the supporters, but it must have been heartbreak for the players, and I'm sure that's what will drive them on to win next Sunday.
What about the Wexford team? How good are they?
Well, they've come through a tough campaign. They've beaten Offaly, Kilkenny, Dublin and Galway. Their series of wins has been as impressive as ours, but I think that our team is more mature on All-Ireland Day, and hopefully that will prove the small difference that will be in the next Sunday.
Well, on our left we have Liam Hurley here of Mona Gay, the home of the Limerick Inter-County Hurling player John Flavin, and prior to that Willie Hawk, who captains Limerick to win an All-Ireland a number of years ago, and alongside him we have the County Chairman of the Limerick County Board in Brendan Danner, and to the right we have Seamus Hennessy, a broadcaster with Limerick 95, receiving a courtesy car to travel in style with the sports team and indeed the Limerick 95 crew to a historic All-Ireland final. That's what we hope in Limerick at least.
Thanks very much, Liam. It's lovely being associated with you.
Right,
Mr. Denner, thanks for coming along.
Thank you very much.